In a Broadway season that's been plagued by closings and actors' departures, one production has risen to the top. Wicked, a reimagination of the lives of the witches from The Wizard of Oz, has met with critical praise and audience delight. It has an award-winning creative team with music and lyrics by Stephen Schwartz and direction by Joe Mantello. Joining me now for a conversation about the newest hit on Broadway is the show's stars, Idina Menzel and Kristen Chenoweth. Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you.
Let's start by the first memory you have about either the book or the movie of The Wizard of Oz. Do you remember it?
What's my first memory? Is usually what I say is is Margaret Hamilton riding on the bicycle, and that eerie music used to be the scary point for me.
Certainly for me too. I remember it actually keeping me up one night, and I got up and I went, go back to bed and just think about riding your new bike, and I dreamt about riding my new bike as the witch was following behind me, so it followed me as well. What was your first memory?
Well, I grew up in Oklahoma, so I'm very familiar with tornadoes, and I remember thinking, oh, there goes the cow, and just like I've seen, and the tornadoes. The tornado was really a big kind of thing, and probably the flying monkeys, too. They scared me.
I don't want to give too much away about this story because there's so many surprises that people should go to Wicked and just experience it. But, you know, let's tease enough to give people an idea. It's the story of the Green Witch and the Good Witch. I won't even say the Wicked Witch, the Green Witch. And what happens before Dorothy gets there? What else do you want us to know?
It's the story of the two witches before Dorothy gets there. It actually starts with their relationship in college at Shiz University, and it chronicles their lives sort of past when Dorothy
is there. And if they were friends.
Little do we know. I mean, later on, if you've been watching Judy Garland all these years, it started off that they were friends. I think that's really great for people to sort of get that history or made up backstory history, and that's tons of fun. Part of the fact that you are roommates, right, in the musical, is that it's two female leads. We're used to having a male and a female lead in a musical, and sometimes a male and a male. It's very rare to have two females. How do you feel about that?
Well, we love it. No, we do. We think it's important. We think it makes a good statement for, you know, musical theater today and the importance of having two strong women characters. And
it's a great message also for not just women, but for everybody about, you know, always wanting what the other person has, and these women who can be tricky with each other, but yet they love each other. So it's just a great friendship. And I think people of all ages are responding to, mostly in the show, about this relationship. And that's what's unique about our show.
Well, I love the show because it has these amazing, beautiful sets and costumes and all the bells and whistles that a lot of people come to see musicals for. But it also has this really intimate story. And we're in this huge theater. The Gershwin is
the largest theater on Broadway.
And yet it's this very personal story about these two women. And somehow, I think Joe Mantello and the rest of the creative staff really found a great way of taking this huge theater and having this story grow into it, and then with lighting and with sets, really kind of...
They've really, I mean, just the way that the stage comes in and the wood and the vines, and it has an intimate feel even though it's a huge show.
Mm-hmm. Let's talk about both your entrances. First with you, Kristen. Tell me about your entrance or what you want us to know.
I think we just didn't have a choice with Linda. She had to come in the bubble, and I do actually come in a bubble, and actually it does blow, have bubbles coming out, which is nice, except for when the bubble machine breaks and pours all over my face.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yes, yes. Sorry. I'll be singing in liquid liquid bubble juice, I guess we'll call it.
Does that happen very often?
Not too often. I'll be like, let us be. Or sometimes I swallow bubbles.
Oh.
Or I pop them with my wand if I get real bored.
I didn't know that.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. But it's probably the best entrance I'll ever have. It's definitely tops the. I'm so lucky. I mean, Universal really helped the character out a lot by letting her do
and,
that.
And helps the entire show because people just love Kristen so much. And so the fact that she sort of opens it up and embraces the audience and they just, the show starts in such a high point and they're so warm already and so loving of us because of her that we just, it makes our jobs a lot easier.
And your entrance, too, you don't come in on a bubble. As a matter of fact, unless it's changed since I went there, you just come pretty much down center stage, and you are there. And I think it's just because word of mouth on the show, or maybe people have come back and seen you, and they know you're a powerhouse, and they know they're in for a great night in the theater. You get quite a response when you come
in. Well, not to downplay me. I mean, I would love that's a compliment to me. But I also think that they're excited to see the Green Girl. They're rooting for her already because they know that what they grew up seeing in the movie and thinking of this horrible woman, that they're going to actually, experience something different. And they see this idealistic girl come out, a smile from ear to ear and looking at school and her new beginning. That I think there's a joint emotion going on there for me, I hope, and also for
they think
the
they know, and same with Glinda. I mean, they're like, Glinda, it's Glinda. Oh my gosh, it's the Green Witch. And look, she's got a big smile on her face.
Right, right. She's not the big ugly person,
yeah,
and she's not really mean yet or upset. She's just misunderstood.
Yeah.
That's it. Just a word or two about the makeup. I doing 8 shows a week. That must be really tough for you.
It's not. I mean, I have to be honest. It's enjoyable. I have a great team of people that help me with it, and I've gotten really close with them, and so it's fun. And it actually isn't that heavy. It's water based. It's almost like watercoloring my face. I have a feeling sometimes she probably has more makeup on with her glitter and stuff than I do. But just as far as the producers are concerned, it's very difficult, it's very hard, and I need 2 facials a month.
And then lots of time, lots of pampering. Okay.
Yeah,
definitely.
Speaking of your complexion, I can't help but mention that there's also sort of a racial allegory in this story. It's called to attention that you are put down upon, and that's part of the story. Speak to that for a moment.
I think it's just about anybody who's different. It could be about a racial thing, it could be about a handicap, it's the way people treat people that they're not accustomed to, that feel threatening to them in some way. And I think that it makes everyone think about that when they see the show.
Talk to me about the score. It seems to me that it's a powerhouse for both of you, that it requires a lot physically. It amazes me that Broadway performers do this 8 times a week and that you're scheduled to do this through the summer. I just, what kind of reserves does it take to be able to pull this off?
For me personally, I think everybody's different, but the challenge for me in this show is, when I enter, I'm singing opera, high, legit, and then popular is a music theater belt number, and then the duet we sing is very in my low register, so it's sort of all over the map for me, and that's very challenging. It's certainly a lot more challenging than I thought it would be. I thought, oh, I can do that. But it's with the speaking and the different tones that I also use in my speaking voice for the character, it is challenging. And I don't really like to do much else when I'm doing the show. And again, I've had to realize that the show is first priority and you can't say yes to a lot of outside activities because it does require so much energy. And also, for me, and I know for Idina, the emotional journey is much more demanding than I realized. Because for Glinda, the last 20 minutes are, well, the whole second act is a big change. And it's this girl you think you know, and then there's a change that happens towards the end where she actually becomes good. And it's very emotional, and it's very draining, and very difficult to do 8 times a week, but very
rewarding. Twice a day on some
days. And twice a day,
on some days.
But very rewarding.
You both get to perform with your husband, Taye Diggs, who is in this show. That must be fun. You've performed with him before, right?
I did. I met him in Rent. We were both in the original cast of Rent, and that's where we met.
And to complicate things even better, it's a love interest between the two of you.
Yes, she gets to kiss him. And that's okay, because I love her.
Aw, that's sweet. I promise I won't stick my tongue down.
We're taking notes here. I'm going to have you...
She might stick her tongue down my throat.
Yeah, right.
Sign right here on that. And of course, I assume that adds a whole other level, being an African-American man talking about a racial...
Well,
I mean, that
changes... Taye's taking over, temporarily replacing Norbert, our first love,
yes.
Who's originated the role, and who's just having... had an injury, and he's getting better right now. So I figured, you know, if I can't have Norbert, then the second best person would be my
husband.
And so Norbert is a Caucasian man, and that works fine.
Yeah.
But
this will be great.
I think actually in Gregory Maguire's novel, he insinuates that Vera was a man of, it was ethnic, more tribal and stuff like that. Yeah. So it was interesting because it really brings out that racism
propaganda
element.
Right.
Too. Yeah.
And talk to me about being on stage with the legendary Joel Grey.
I get to dance with him, so, I mean, just, I don't know how you feel about
it. Well, he spends all his time in my dressing room, showing me how to apply my makeup. No, I'm kidding. He is just from the old school, and he's the real deal, and he is what I...
You must have both grown up hearing cabaret
sure.
and all those great musicals.
And when we were doing the Broadway Cares Everybody Has AIDS, auction after our show, he two nights he sang Willkommen, and the audience just went ballistic.
I mean, it brought
right,
tears.
Sure.
The whole
tears.
Side of the stage, the crew, oh, yeah. everybody was just. It was very highly emotional, and you know, I got to call my mom and dad, and say ha ha ha. It's really neat.
You're both likely to be nominated for a Tony Award. I mean, and yet you seem like you get along with each other and do really well. Has it challenged your relationship to be in a musical where it's about competition?
I
don't think we could do the performances we're doing if we didn't have this mutual respect and admiration for one another. It just wouldn't work. That's a chemistry thing. I think that, you know, that there's just something that we just communicate with one another, and if there's something that we're not sure, you know, we really try to be open, and I find that she's extremely supportive.
I really don't think about the award or the award stuff or the, I think about what my peers feel, people mm-hmm. that I trust, and how we're working together. I'm pleasing my director. That's what I think about, and hopefully And I think about the audience, and I think that speaks for itself. They're on their feet every night. We're packing them in at the Gershwin, the biggest house, and, mm-hmm. you know, there you go.
Well, congratulations. You got a hit on your hand, Idina Menzel.
Thank you.
Pleasure
Thanks
to meet
so
you.
Thanks for having me.
Kristen Chenoweth, good to see you again.
You too.
Everything that really counts to be popular, I'll help you be popular. You'll hang with the right cohorts. You'll be good at sports. Know the slang you've got to know. So let's start.
Wicked is currently running on Broadway at the Gershwin Theater. The Wicked CD is in stores now. For more information, go to wickedthemusical.com.